Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. In today's video, we are going to explore one of the core concepts in a Drupal development, that is hooks. So what exactly is hooks in a Drupal? Let's find out. A hook is a point in a Drupal code where models can interact with the core system. Hooks are used to extend Drupal's functionality, add new features, or modify existing behavior. I found one very easy explanation on the Drupal Stacks Exchange. So here it is mentioned that hooks is a point where the core pauses and shouts, "Anyone else got anything to add here?" So it means when the Drupal core functionality is executing, and if we want to add any custom functionality in between that functionality, that time we use the hooks. Hooks in a Drupal are PHP functions with specific names and parameters. These functions are defined in a custom module or in custom theme and are called by the Drupal at specific during its execution. By implementing these hooks, developers can add their custom code and modify Drupal's behavior to suit their needs. Hooks in a Drupal are named following a specific pattern. The name starts with hook underscore followed by the descriptive keyword or phrases related to the hook purpose. For example, hook underscore theme, hook underscore preprocess, and the hook underscore form underscore alter. While implementing these hooks, we need to replace this hook with our custom module name or the theme name. For example, here in my hello world module, I have declared the underscore theme module and replaced the hook with my module name. So this hook underscore theme is used to pass the variables to the tweak template. Same way, you can add the hooks in a dot theme file of your custom theme. Like here I have one theme. In that theme you can see this preprocess underscore page hook. There are numerous hooks available in a Drupal covering various aspects such as theming, database manipulation, form handling, and more. So here you can find the list of all available hooks in a Drupal. Hook underscore form alter. These are the few frequently used hooks in a Drupal. These hooks provide developers with a vast range of possibilities to customize Drupal and integrate their own functionality seamlessly. Let's quickly look at an example of implementing a hook in a Drupal. Suppose you want to alter the behavior of your login form by implementing the hook underscore form underscore alter. You can modify the form elements, add validation, or perform the additional actions. So I will show you the quick example how to implement the hook underscore form underscore alter in our custom model. For that, go to our custom model. So I have already developed this hello world model, and go to the hello world.model file. In this file we will implement the hook underscore form underscore alter hook. Implements hook underscore form underscore alter. After that we need to mention the hook name, so we will replace this hook underscore with our model name. Our model name is hello underscore world underscore form underscore alter. So this hook saves the three parameters. Those are ampersand dollar form, comma slash Drupal slash core slash form slash form state interface variable as a form underscore state. And third parameter is form ID. Now check the form ID. So you can find the form ID by inspecting that form. So for this, the form ID is this. We need to replace the hyphen with the underscore to get the form ID. If dollar form underscore ID equal to user underscore login underscore form, so right now you can see here the title for this form is login, and using the form underscore alter hook we will change this title. For that, dollar form hash title equal to t function, and write the text you want to show. So I will write the title as login with your credentials. Save this file and now clear the cache. I will clear the cache using the address here. The cache is clear. Now go to the form and refresh the page. This title should get changed to the as per this login with your credential. I will refresh this page. So here you can see the title is changed using the hook underscore form underscore alter. Same way, if you want to change this username and replace it with the email, for that again write like this name. This is the name of this username field. You can find it that here, and we want to change the attribute as a title, so we'll change it to the email. Save this again, clear the cache. So the cache is clear. Now again refresh the page. The username should get changed to the email. So here we can see the username is changed to the email. In this example, the hello underscore world underscore form underscore alt function is called whenever a form is being built, specifically targeting the user login form. It modifies the form title and the title of the username field. And that's the power of hooks in a Drupal. They allow developers to tap into Drupal's extensibility and tailor the platform to their specific requirement. Whenever it's altering forms, customizing menus, or enhancing the theming process, hooks provide a flexible and modular way to extend Drupal's functionality. I hope this video helps you in understanding what hooks are in a Drupal and how they can be leveraged in your projects. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more Drupal tutorials and updates. If you have any question or topics you would like us to cover, let us know in the comments below. Happy coding and see you next time.